put your daughter on the stage, Mrs. Worthington. Don't put your daughter on the stage. The profession is overcrowded, and the struggle's pretty tough. And admitting the fact she's burning to act, that isn't quite enough. She has nice hands to give the wretched girl her due, but don't you think her bust is too developed for her age? I repeat, Mrs. Worthington, sweet Mrs. Worthington, don't put your daughter on stage. Regarding yours, dear Mrs. Worthington, on Wednesday the 23rd, although your baby may be keen on stage career, how do I make this clear? This is not a good idea for her to hope, dear Mrs. Worthington, is on the face a bit absurd. Her personality is not in reality inviting enough, exciting enough for this particular sphere. Don't put your daughter on the stage, Mrs. Worthington. Don't put your daughter on the stage. She's a bit of an ugly duckling, you must honestly confess. And the width of her seat would surely defeat her chances of success. It's a loud voice, and though it's not exactly flat, she'll need a little more than that to earn a living wage. On my knees, Mrs. Worthington, please, Mrs. Worthington, don't put your daughter on the stage. Don't put your daughter on the stage, Mrs. Worthington. Don't put your daughter on the stage. Though they said at the School of Acting she was lovely as Hugh Gint, I'm afraid in the whole an ingenue role would emphasize her squint. She's a big girl, and though her teeth are fairly good, she's not the type I ever would be eager to engage. No more buts, Mrs. Worthington. Nuts, Mrs. Worthington. Don't put your daughter on the stage. Don't put your daughter on the stage. One look at her bare legs will prove she hasn't got a chance. In addition to which, that son of a bitch can neither sing nor dance. She's a vile girl, and uglier than mortal sin. One look at her has put me in a tearing bloody rage. That sufficed, Mrs. Worthington. Christ, Mrs. Worthington, don't put your daughter on the stage.